150 years of excellence in higher education. First envisioned by founder Brigadier General Samuel Chapman Armstrong, and 40 years of accelerated growth and solvency under the insightful leadership of Dr. William R. Harvey. Hampton is an academic force recognized around the world as the standard of excellence. From the beginning, Hampton University provided the African American community with exactly what it needed. Founder Brigadier General Samuel Chapman Armstrong was convinced that newly freed slaves desperately needed a solid education in order to advance to a state of self-sustaining financial stability. He established a guiding doctrine that embraced education of the head, the heart, and the hand. Current and longest-serving President Dr. William R. Harvey has taken that philosophy to unimaginable heights. Hampton has transformed from a trade school to a world-class academic and research institution known for being first. The first and only HBCU granted 100% control of a NASA satellite mission. Hampton currently has 4 satellites in orbit, researching the ionosphere and planetary science. A Hampton weather antenna looms atop the highest building in the city, gathering weather patterns in real time for meteorologists near and far. The first to build the world's largest freestanding proton therapy cancer treatment center, easing human misery and saving lives. The first HBCU to field a Division I men's lacrosse team, making worldwide news on ESPN. The first university and only HBCU to offer a PhD in atmospheric and planetary sciences, one of 8 PhDs offered at Hampton. The first institution to offer higher education to Native Americans. America was in the midst of the first wave of the Industrial Revolution when this great institution was founded. There was a deafening call for skilled artisans. Hampton answered that call, training newly freed slaves with the requisite skills to excel and become self-sufficient. General Armstrong insisted that Hampton graduates exhibit good character and be equipped to lead. His educational mission delved deeper, strengthening the inner core of the student, reaching them by employing an educational model that touched the head, the heart, and the hand, sustaining an education for life. The Hampton Scholar was taught to lead by example, work hard, purchase land, and build wealth. He encouraged community leadership. General Samuel Chapman Armstrong had the right idea when he founded Hampton University, and Dr. William R. Harvey, the 12th president of this stellar institution, has wisely continued Armstrong's legacy in legendary ways. The early years in Hampton's history are noted in the annals as robust. The institution flourished as largely a vocational education school, training African American and Native American students in the trades. It attracted students from all over the country, one of whom would become its most prominent graduate, Booker T. Washington. When education proponents in Tuskegee, Alabama asked General Armstrong to recommend a leader for their newly funded teacher school for African Americans, he offered his mentee. And in true Armstrong-inspired fashion, Washington famously went on to establish Tuskegee Institute, which Booker T. Washington modeled after his alma mater, Hampton. During the 1920s, black scholars began to question educational philosophies. Debates raged on whether African Americans should be trained as skilled laborers instead of in pure academics. General Samuel Chapman Armstrong stayed on mission and wavered not. His head, heart, and hand model for creating leaders was sound, trusted, and proven as key to providing an undeniable education for life. Whether the student's passion was best channeled through the hand or the head, the Hampton student had the heart and mind to discern and chart a path to success in all sectors. The decade of the 1930s ushered in a period of growth and development. The Hampton Normal and Agricultural Institute became Hampton Institute, further widening the spectrum of opportunities for students of color, both men and women, in higher education. During the 1950s, programs in physics, mathematics, and chemistry were curriculum strongholds, underscoring Hampton's boundless success in preparing some of the first leaders in the sciences. Hampton University President Dr. Jerome Holland led the Institute through the civil rights era of the 1960s. During his tenure, enrollment increased substantially. More faculty were hired, a dozen buildings were completed, and programs like the mass media arts and computer technology were added, keeping the school relevant in the eyes of students. But perhaps the most astounding period of growth began in 1978 when Dr. William R. Harvey took hold of the reins. The Harvard-trained educator employed an unprecedented business acumen to the presidency that escalated the status and performance of the institution exponentially. The growth was and continues to be staggering. Enrollment has more than doubled. 92 programs have been added, including undergraduate programs in computer science, marine science, chemical, electrical, and computer engineering and journalism. Doctoral programs in pharmacy, physical therapy, nursing, business, physics, and atmospheric sciences. 30 new structures dot the landscape of this beautiful campus surrounded on three sides by water. And the endowment has increased from $29 million to $280 million and growing. In 1984, this burgeoning institute was transformed into what we now celebrate as Hampton University. In sum, Dr. Harvey has transformed Hampton University from a small black college to a world-class leader in the field of higher education. Today, the university boasts a number of distinctions that set it apart from other mid-sized institutions in the nation. Students are afforded the unique opportunities to engage in an equestrian program and to join the sailing team. Faculty are poised at the leading edge of discovery with patents on such items as a breast cancer detection device and prostheses for amputated limbs. Dr. Harvey is distinguished as one of the longest tenured presidents in the country, and his contributions to our home by the sea are never ending. Happy 150th birthday, Hampton University. And to Dr. William R. Harvey, happy 40th anniversary.